Strong walls protect us from uninvited guests. Old towns were built to last. They used materials which they could find nearby, and the walls were really heavy and thick. Then humans created bricks. This innovation made construction building more efficient. The problem with bricks is that mounting them is time-consuming and they are too heavy. After a while, people started to look for something bigger and lighter.
Three, the most popular modern stones are autoclaved aerated concrete block, expanded clay block, and hollow concrete block. The most common block in my country is the AAC block. It consists of quartz sand, gypsum, lime, cement, water, and aluminium powder. So they mix everything together and add aluminium powder last, which generates air bubbles through the chemical reaction. Then they cut them and wrap in the film. When blocks arrive on an object, they are wet. To understand how much water they can absorb, I have made a small test.
I weighted all these completely dry pieces and placed them in water for a week. Notice that the AAC block is so light that it did not sink even in 1 week. It has closed pores, so they absorb water for a long time. Anyways, in 1 week, the AAC block absorbed 1,246 grams, which is 59% of its weight. The expanded clay block absorbed 737 grams, which is 20% of its weight. And the concrete block absorbed around 600 grams, which is 6% of its weight. For complete drying, the AAC block needed 45 days, the expanded clay block 35 days, and the concrete block 20 days.
As you see, the AAC block collects water the most. The bigger block, the more time it needs to dry. The problem is that usually there is no time to dry them before laying, which means that walls are wet. This is the reason why producers of that block don't suggest to use foam isolation on that block. Mineral isolation is breathable, so water can escape from the walls. The second problem with the moist wall is shrinkage. During the drying, materials tend to shrink. In some cases, cracks may occur.
AAC blocks are mounted with foam or cement-based glue. The glue layer is really thin and glue shrinks more than a mortar. If you have a few millimeters teeth, like here, and you lay brick on that, then there is no support. The heavy wall is pressing on that area and oppa, cracks here. That is why grinding blocks is important. Concrete and clay blocks use the usual mortar. Mortar has a thick layer and it doesn't shrink that much, so no need to grind every row.
Cracks caused by shrinkage or unprofessional workers are usually small and can be plastered. Big cracks are caused by a bad foundation. I'm gonna talk about foundations in the next video, so make sure to subscribe my channel so you don't miss the valuable information. A big benefit of this block is the weight. Lighter material has better insulation. Some homes are built with half meter wide blocks and they don't need extra insulation. Lighter walls suit better for plate type foundation. In some cases, heavy walls mean significant increase in foundation works. AAC blocks dimensions are usually really accurate, which means that plastering them is simple. Installing cables on these walls is really easy.
Local AAC block producer sells rebar which saves a lot of installation time. But I suggest using the old school method. For me, it feels stronger. Just make this simple gadget by yourself and you save time and money and work is cleaner.
Overall, a good warm block when installed properly and without a rush. Quite expensive compared to competitors, especially the bridges. But they need less insulation, so altogether the price difference is small. Expanded clay blocks are made from clay and concrete. They heat clay to some crazy hot temperatures and by that they get these small balls. Then they glue them together with concrete. Since fabricating them is cheaper, there are many manufacturers. The quality of these blocks depends on the producer. I have worked with bad quality stones. Their dimensions are not accurate and they feel weaker while cutting. Good quality blocks are really hard to cut and dimensions are accurate, which makes work easier. Modern expanded clay blocks don't need mortar on sides, which makes installation really easy. I think that this block is easiest to lay.
With expanded clay blocks, special rebar is used. Since they have small holes in them, they are not hermetic, so they need thicker plaster. I suggest using foam isolation on these blocks.
Overall, expanded clay blocks are the easiest to use and walls from them are the cheapest. The hollow concrete block is the heaviest and strongest. It is made of cement and sand. Only block where vertical rebar is used. Because of proper reinforcement, these walls are really strong.
I know that according to engineers, there is no need to fill all holes with concrete. But I personally would recommend filling all holes, since reinforcement need concrete to work properly. If there are mistakes in the foundation, then rebar does reduce peak problems and increase house lifetime.
There are blocks which don't need a vertical mortar, so it is easier to lay them. Still, these blocks are the most time-consuming. You need extra time to cut and install rebar. Holes need to be filled after every meter, so with one house you need to order concrete at least 3 times. Building bridges is cheap but time-consuming. If you are a do-it-yourself guy and you don't mind mixing cement, sand and rocks by yourself, then you can get solid walls with a similar price as with lighter blocks. Blocks themselves are the cheapest. Walls of concrete are many times heavier, so make sure that you do have possibilities for a proper foundation. Concrete blocks are sensitive to the vibrations. Sometimes cracks may appear. I have seen how they crack while concrete casting.
Fresh concrete consists of cement, sand, rocks and water. The more you vibrate fresh concrete, the more stones settle. With vibrations, these stones try to find a way to go further, so they just press block until it cracks. Happens often with using a too powerful vibrator or when the vibrating process is too long.
All of these blocks are made for living houses, so you can pick any of them. And if you still can't decide, then my suggestions are:
for a one-story house, use AAC block. If you plan to insulate with foam isolation, use expanded clay block. For a two-story house with a wooden second floor deck, use expanded clay block. And with a concrete floor, use concrete block.
Just follow the producer's recommendations and installation instructions. And of course, have a proper project for your house to avoid costly problems.
The last topic I want to talk about is climate. Today is sunny but chilly weather. This stone has been on the sun all day. It is warm to touch. When the sun goes down, the stone remains warm for some time. This is called accumulation. The heavier material, the better it accumulates. Let's imagine that there are two exactly the same houses in the same location. The only difference is that one is built with concrete walls, but the other with the AAC block walls. The house with concrete walls needs a longer time to heat up, but when the house is warm, the climate is more stable. For example, if both houses have the same temperature inside and outside is colder, then when you open all the windows for half an hour and then close them and wait another half an hour, then house with concrete walls remains warmer. This accumulation is good in countries where daily temperature changes frequently, since house heating source has a smaller work ratio. Okay guys, this video is now finished, so you can click on some end screen. And special thanks to my 200 subscribers who are supporting my channel.